served. Sophia, could you come here a moment? Yes, ma'am? Pour me some wine. Yes, ma'am. But madam... Oh, what is it, George? I must protest. It has always been my duty to bring the wine at dinner. Oh, well, I didn't want to cause any trouble. Nonsense. What does it matter, George? Stop being overly pedantic. But I... that's... aggressive... no... come on, let George pour the wine. Just let him pour the damn wine, would you? It's his job. You stay out of it, boy. If your mother wants the girl to pour the damn wine, then the girl will pour the damn wine. Okay, maybe that wasn't the right choice. Of course, sir, my apologies. An interfering little rat, isn't he, Daddy? Yes, he is. Why can't you ever keep your mouth shut, boy? So we're just gonna apologize. You're right. I'm sorry. I must have had too much wine myself. You better not let it happen again. Sophia, could you come here, please? Yes, Miss Jennifer? I just want to say that was the loveliest meal I've ever tasted. I don't know how you do it, you cunning pixie. You're too kind, miss. Of course, I will have tea and cakes for you in the drawing room as usual after dinner. Oh, you're so good to me, you sweet thing. So very, very good to me. We're just gonna keep it neutral. I won't have any, thank you. I can't eat another bite. Well, you weren't offered any, so there. Please, Jennifer, let's all try to be civil. Anyway, let's not forget why we are here today. To celebrate your father's birthday. Such a very important occasion for us all. You are so dear to us, Malcolm. Happy birthday, Daddy. Indeed, happy birthday, Father. Let's hope it will be one to remember. Doing the deed. Now is the time to quickly plant any items of evidence you have. To do so, simply enter the desired room and select the item in your inventory. When you're ready, enter the drawing room to do the deed. So, it looks like we're going to pin it on the poor maid because I couldn't figure out another way to do this. Sorry, girl. Nothing personal. I just hate my sister. And apparently murder is the way to fix this. So, actually we're going to escape real quick and save. Come hither, thou sweet and flame-haired maiden. Let us play the games which have been forbade in dusty old rooms of this home in which I live, and come hither to me and do my sweet bidding. When you're yourself unable to continue reading this poem, you're pretty sure that forbidden isn't a word, and the rest doesn't really rhyme. Do you want to plant? Yes, let's plant the item here. Yes, I did conceal the item beneath the maid's pillow. That ought to be quite incriminating. Hopefully that is correct. Are you sure you want to enter the drawing room? Once inside, there is no turning back. Yes. You see Jennifer standing in the window ahead of you, lost in another strange room. She hasn't noticed you enter the drawing room. That was the door. So let's go. Thank you. just going to sit with our mother. And she'll discover our dead sister. There we go. Good evening, everyone. I'm Chief Inspector Winston Lewis. I understand that this is a difficult time for your family. You're damn right it is. I want to know what you're doing wasting time in here while my daughter's killer is still out there. Well, Mr. Bruce, you have found no evidence of forced entry and nobody was seen entering or leaving the house. It would seem entirely possible then that the killer is in this room. What? No! That seems highly unlikely, Inspector. Perhaps it is. However, in order to follow protocol, I will have to interview each of you in turn. Mrs. Bruce, would you like to meet me in the library first? I suppose so. The interview. Thank you for joining me here, Mr. Bruce. I'm sure this won't take long. Before we begin, I will need to search your person. Best to get these formalities out of the way. Is this really necessary? I'm afraid so. Turn around, please. Now that that's out of the way, let's move on to the interview. As you know, I have already spoken to everyone else who was present in the house at the time of your sister's death. We have also now completed our initial search of the house, but we'll get to that later. Let's start from the beginning, shall we? First of all, we will run through all of your activities since your arrival. The maid says that you and the butler arrived shortly after 7 o'clock and she greeted you at the door. Later on, you had a conversation with your mother Gloria in the pot parlor. She told me that you were unusually cordial, something about wanting to apologize and making amends. I was being sincere. Yes, I wanted to clear the air between myself and my family. I see. Do you think it is slightly suspicious that you suddenly want to reconcile after all this time? No, I don't think so. Very well, then. She says you spoke briefly about your sister, apparently, and you seem quite concerned about her well-being. We are worried about my sister attempted suicide attempt. My mother and I were concerned that my sister might try to take her own life, as she had attempted once before. She had she? I will make note of that. It's not really relevant, though, given what we ended up doing. You went to see your father in the library. I understand the conversation became quite heated. My father has always had a temper. My father has a very short fuse. Many of our conversations go that way. Would you say he has a violent temper? Absolutely. I see. That's good to know. You discussed the prospect of moving back to Dunshill. You refused to do so under any circumstances. Why? I already have a life elsewhere. My father fails to accept the fact that I have my own life now. I can't just move back here. Of course not. That's completely understandable. Did you speak to your sister before dinner? Yes, I did. Yes, I went to her room to see her. I see. And what did you discuss? Discuss her illness and her intentions. I spoke about her condition. I was aware that she was going through a particularly difficult time. Did she seem distressed to you? Yes, you could say that. She was not in a good place, mentally speaking. I see. Let's move on to the events that took place during dinner. I understand there was an argument involving the butler. You felt he was being treated unfairly. My family always treats servants poorly. Someone has to stand up for the servants around here. My family treats them like dirt. Indeed. It was good of you to do so, Mr. Bruce. Now, I need to ascertain your location at the time of your sister's death. Where were you when you heard the maid scream? Ground floor. In the... parlor. Was our mother in the parlor or the library? I think it was the parlor. It was in the parlor. Yes, your mother mentioned you were in there with her. No, this is the library. My brain is not working today. Okay. As I said earlier, you have completed our initial search of the property. We found a poem written by your sister, which appears to clearly express romantic feelings towards the maid. Given that it was found in the maid's room, we can be sure that she had read it. Perhaps it is proof that the two of them were involved in a secret relationship that would make her a suspect. I will certainly have more questions for her, at least. I am curious about the murder weapon. The poison had apparently been sprinkled upon some cakes which the maid had prepared. Of course, your sister may have done this herself if it was suicide. It is all very interesting. I will be completely honest with you now, Mr. Bruce. I can find no fault or suspicion in your behavior leading to your sister's death.
Yes!
While there is some suspicion regarding your father, I don't currently regard him as a serious suspect. I also think the evidence surrounding the maid might be worth another look. The possibility of suicide must be considered, although I am personally unconvinced. Now, as for what happens next, you are free to go. I think another interview with the maid will be required also. It is possible that an inquest might return a verdict of suicide. We'll see. Since you had given the police no reason to suspect you, Sophia the maid quickly became the prime suspect in the case and was arrested shortly afterwards. The trial was long and not without controversy, but eventually the jury returned a guilty verdict. The case caused quite a scandal in the national media, and Sophia gained a lot of unwanted celebrity in the process. She became known in the public imagination as the killer chambermaid. With no other heirs remaining, your father reversed his plans to cut you out of his will when your parents died. You inherit everything. Dunshill House was yours, along with the fortune that came with it. However, George, the butler, found himself unable to continue serving in the place after what had happened. As you spent many long, sleepless nights wandering through the rooms of the house, you found that its emptiness was reflected within yourself. You had become hollow inside, free of everything but the nightmares that continued to haunt you. Alright, so that was the Dean. And that's about par for the course for all of the endings, except for the ones where you're caught or it's like unsure of what actually happened. In most cases, so long as you weren't a suspect and you didn't give your father reason to believe that you were a suspect, you got that ending. Otherwise, you were arrested and convicted, or, like, you just didn't get anything. So, that was that. That's all we're going to do of this particular game, The Deed. There's also a game called The Deed Dynasty, which I never completed even one playthrough of, so that will be our next game, I think, for Steam Wednesday. So, let me know what you thought, and thank you for watching.